Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of Lloyds ASMR. Well, I went to the grocery store today, and I came across a video idea . If you all enjoy this video, I have a few more tricks up my sleeve similar to this. Some a little more intense and a little out there, but it should all be relaxing as well as interesting and entertaining. So what I have here today is an abundance of Asian drinks and snacks. As we take a look at each item, we'll go ahead and try it. So, with that said, let's clear the table, make some room, and start off with the main course, the sushi. Okay, here we go. So, what we have here is called the California Combo. It has the California roll, the spicy California roll, and the crunch California roll. These three are probably my favorite. They just have so many, you know, different flavors up in there. And then to go with it, we have ourselves some Thai tea. And here's what that looks like. This should be pretty interesting. I've never had a Thai tea before. So, balanced ingredients. Okay. I think we'll trust them. It actually looks quite delicious. Very refreshing as well. Smells like chocolate milk. Works for me. We have our drink. Now let's try some California rolls. So, looks like they give you a little packet of soy sauce. I have some extra soy sauce here as well. Honestly, have no idea how to properly use chopsticks. But I'll figure it out. Pretty sure it's like that. We're just gonna go with it. what looks to be the plain California roll. Looks like it has a little wasabi on there too. It's really good. I'm getting green tea, matcha, little bit of cocoa, something in that nature. It's really delicious. Very good. With whatever that is on top to make it crunch, but very delicious. A little bit of Thai tea to, you know, to cleanse the palate. Good. is what we're going to do. We're going to put some soy sauce on a row of these. And some wasabi. And some cabbage, I think. It's what it is. And we'll see how that is. There we go. We just totally drenched it. Okay, so let's add some wasabi to each one. And some cabbage to each one. Let's try each one, complete with the works. That definitely spice things up. Okay, on to the next. Thank you. crispy seaweed. And it is Tom Yum Goon flavor, which I think is shrimp flavor. Something similar. Let's see what the contains shrimp. Okay, so I got that right. But this should be really good. I'm surprisingly a fan. Seaweed snacks. So I'm pretty stoked. And for our drink, I have never had anything like Eos White Gourd drink. I've never tasted white gourd before. Should be interesting. Let's get this opened up. Pour our drink and try it out. Okay. Got my trusty scissors. Now, let's get our drink. Now, what does that smell like? Interesting. It almost smells like pretzels. Like salted pretzels. in either shrimp or seaweed. I do smell a faint hint of the seaweed, though. That's pretty good. It does have a bit of a punch, a little bit of heat. Nothing unbearable or anything. Let's try. Seaweed and shrimp flavor. It's really faint. I can barely taste it. I like it. Expect that one. So, not only does it smell like pretzels, but it tastes like pretzels too. I'm getting a faint hint of tea in there somewhere. It's pretty good. Wow. Let's move on to our next drink and snack. Okay. So, we're gonna do a combo. First, we have three delicious seaweed. Lime. Korean barbecue. That might be pretty good. And third, sea salt. Complete with tapioca pearls. Interesting. And next, we have matcha green tea latte with tapioca pearls. Tried any of these, so it'll be a surprise. Okay, so everything here is going to be pretty loud, so I'm going to open everything off camera. I'll be right back. Let's pour our drinks. So, here's the taro. And here's the green tea. So let's start with the chili lime. Love the sound of that. Smell seaweed, but I smell a real faint hint of lime. It smells pretty good. Let's try it. Yeah. They're so thin. Yeah, the more you put in your mouth, the better. Melts in your mouth. Well, so far, the chili lime is really good. And it's number one in my books right now, so. But we'll see how the other two hold out. So this here is the taro or taro. Cheers. This reminds me of is at the end of your bowl of cereal, the leftover milk, but this one in particular would be Captain Crunch leftover. There's no tapioca balls. At least I didn't get any. I don't know if they're hidden in the bottom or something, but yeah, I didn't get any tapioca balls in there. Korean barbecue. I'm gonna have 3 of these. Spicy like I thought it would be, but I do taste a nice mild barbecue flavor. It's very nice. I smell the matcha green tea. That much sea salt flavor. It's like a microscopic amount of sea salt flavor. Real tiny. The chili lime, and of course third would be the sea salt. My favorite drink out of the two is the matcha green tea latte. It's amazing. Okay, well, let's move on to our next drink and snack. Funnel cake. It looks nothing like this. So I'm interested in seeing if it has any similarities. As for our drink, we have a Vietnamese coffee with milk, and I don't even know how to pronounce that. I'm going to guess café shui. Was a little loud, but here is what it looks like. Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle. Smells like funnel cake. Like the one I'm used to. Okay, well, that's gonna be interesting. As for our coffee. Got our cup. Okay, so I'll let you on a little secret. This coffee literally smells like McDonald's coffee. I kid you. Should be pretty good. Sure smells good. All right. Let's try this out. So, yeah, it feels like it would be hard as a rock, but when you bite down on it, it's like soft as foam. The taste. Thank you. So it's not as strong in flavor like the funnel cakes I'm used to. But it still tastes like a funnel cake. I'm surprised. And I'll tell you what. I definitely buy this again. I might put some powdered sugar either on top of it or just coat the whole thing. You know, just to sweeten the deal. Wow. Really, I'm surprised. Myself a new snack. Let's try that coffee. Nice cup of gel to go with the funnel cake. Perfect. This. It's just as good as the Starbucks lattes that you can get in that little jar. It's amazing. So creamy and flavorful. Wow. Another unexpected delight. Thank you. So, to finish up, we have dessert. Starting with mango pudding jelly. Honeydew pudding jelly. Lychee pudding jelly. Mango fruitery. Let's start with the mango pudding jelly. Now, is it pudding or is it jelly? Guess there's only one way to find out. Minus the juice on top. So it's like a pudding mixed with jello. The name pudding jelly makes sense. Tastes like a real creamy mango. The texture is, you know, but it's still good. Let's try the honeydew. I love honeydew. Thank you. It's rare. But apparently there's little chunks of fruit hidden within there. It scared me. I bit down on something and I was like, what is that? But it's a little chunk of fruit. Okay, so the honeydew could use a little more flavor. The mango has more flavor than the honeydew. Let's try the lychee. As far as I know, I've never had lychee. Not lychee. So, apparently it's floral. Honestly, it almost smells like a candle. Like a really strong scented candle. Put a wick in it, look like a candle. I'm nervous. I love mango, and I love honeydew, but for some weird, strange reason, I really enjoy that. Who would have known? Okay, well. This is like a little shot. Completely different from this one. And again, they stuck a little piece of mango in there. But yeah, This was definitely more of a jelly. And not a jelly pudding mix. And the flavor in that little shot was pretty amazing. It's a really good mango. This is Lloyds ASMR, signing off. Stay safe, stay happy, stay healthy, and of course,